Somebody call 911. Shoddy fire.
Hello. For our chicken cremation, we decided to imitate the Lords of Kakan from the Mayan late post-classic period. The cremation for the Lords of Kakan began beheading the bodies, then continuing with defleshing the bodies by boiling them until the skin peeled off the bones. We began by putting our 4.6-pound chicken, Carol, into a pot of boiling water. We boiled the water for 2 hours, and occasionally pulling out the flesh as it fell off the bones. We got a skull and clay to recreate the beheaded bodies. The Lords of Kakan took the skulls and remade the face with a specific type of clay. It was called Buitin. While the chicken was boiling, we decorated our long neck jar, which happened to be a wine bottle, with silver flames. Once the bodies were defleshed, the long bones were removed from the body. We placed the femurs and humeruses to the side as they would traditionally be turned into artwork for the deceased. On the day of the cremation, we planned to create a pyre out of wood. The Lords of Kakan had been taken into a room and boiled, and burned in private. Our research didn't give us information about what they were burning, so we chose to do a pyre to ensure the burning process would surround the chicken. We dug a square hole about 2 feet by 2 feet, lined it with stones to help with containing the fire. On the dirt, we placed newspaper and straw to help make the burn surround the chicken. Then we created a 5-level pyre out of wood and sticks with occasional newspaper as kindling. The fire began burning at 9:20 a.m. and we stopped adding firewood at 10:28 a.m. The fire burned until 11:30 a.m., giving a total of about 2 hours of cremating the chicken. Throughout the cremation process, we checked the temperatures to ensure it was above 600 degrees Fahrenheit. After the coals were cooled, we could sift through the coals to find ashes and remains from the chicken. We found many small pieces of bones, including parts of the vertebrae, ribs, and possible scapula of the chicken. We analyzed the bones to see if they were able to be sexed and concluded that they were too small and fragmented to sex or age. We feel like our experiment was a success because the remains found were very small and difficult to age and sex. In an overall comparison with the Lords of Kakan cremations, we concluded our experiment gave us very close results and a very good example of to what a post-classic Mayan cremation would look like.